Hi everybody, I'm Jeff from Missouri Wind and Solar, and today I want to show you how to install a solar panel on an RV. This one is our little pop-up A-frame travel trailer, and I'm going to put a 50-watt solar panel on the roof permanently. Now, in a previous video, I made a portable solar charging unit, which is right here. And this just folds up, it has a built-in charge controller. And you can plug it in to the ZAMP solar power jack, and or you can use the alligator clips to just clip it right to your battery. And you can be out boondocking, not worry about electricity. But anyway, rather than the portable unit, which I'm still going to use, I want to add a solar panel permanently to the roof of this. And while it's even closed down and sitting in storage, the solar panel will be always charging the battery. I'm going to install a charge controller in this too. Okay, this is the 50 watt solar panel I'm putting on the roof. And I do have room for 100 watts up there, but I want to try 50 watt first and see if that's all that we're going to need. Now this RV is all LED light, so it uses very little power. But we have a 12 volt refrigerator on the inside. These are the things that you're going to need to do this, and it's called a screwless solar panel mounting kit. We got this at the store. Now, to put the mounts on the roof of your RV, you're going to need to buy a tube of Sikaflex 252. And this is like an industrial adhesive. And it will hold those brackets down. You won't have to worry about them coming off. Now I bought a 50-foot roll of MC4 cable, solar panel cable, that I'm going to split in half, and I'll show you that in a minute. We got my junction box here that I'll be running my cables through. Those are waterproof connectors, nice big flange. And I'm going to be installing this PWM solar charge controller. That's just a 10 amp controller. It's all I need. But it's going to show me the battery voltage. And right now, I don't know what the battery voltage is, the state of battery charge is in this RV. There's no meters in it at all. So this is going to be my new meter. You're also going to need to get a can of xylene to clean the roof of your RV. Get off the wax and dirt. And xylene is like an industrial solvent. It's just a cleaner. So you probably want to wear some gloves when you're using that xylene. Listen, it'll strip the wax and everything right off your finish so that you can glue down your parts. Now here are the four screwless mounting brackets. And last night I glued them to the roof, so we didn't have to wait for the glue to dry. Anyway, I cleaned the surface with xylene really well. I let the xylene dry, then I put the Sikaflex on the brackets, and I got one corner bracket mounted real nice, and then I just set my solar panel up there and adjusted all the brackets, and I put some weight on the solar panel last night. So let the Sikaflex dry at least 24 hours. That's really nice and tight, and it's ready to go ahead and mount. Now, I'm not going to glue my solar panel in because if this doesn't work out and I want to put another 50 watt on the other side of the trailer, which I have room for, I want to be able to take this off. So I'm going to go ahead and put some self-tapping screws in through these brackets to hold my panel. Okay, so this is what I'm going to do. I bought 50 foot of solar cable. I got a male and female end on the cable, MC4 connectors. I'm just going to stretch this out and clip it in half. And it's going to be more than enough that I'm going to need for this job. Okay, in the back of your solar panel, you have a negative and you have a positive. So I'll just get these plugged together. Make sure they snap tight too. You don't want this coming off on the road on you. Okay, those are locked. Next thing we want to do is mark these cables. So I've got some tape here, and I want to mark some of them positive and negative. So we keep all of this straight while we're installing. You don't want to cross these wires. That's where it's going to go. I'm going to shoot some self-tapping screws into it. Okay, be very careful not to put this screw into the glass or hit the plastic on the back side. There you go. Last cable strap put in. I'm keeping the cables separated all the way. There you go, them look pretty good, keeping them separated right on the trim. I just double up the clamps. I'll finish the front. Okay, that's how that's going to look. Now I got to go inside and figure out where to put our charge controller and come out through the front. There we go. That's going to work out great. Well, that's what it looks like. Okay, the idea is when you pull into a campgrounds, if you're boondocking somewhere, be nice if you can face that panel towards the south. But if for some reason you can't get it faced towards the south, that's where my portable solar charging unit comes in. You can face that any way you like. Okay, so I've got inside. I found the perfect place to go through my wall to hook up my charge controller. Now I'm ready to slide the cables through my waterproof box, which I'll screw and I'll be gluing this up because of this diamond plate here. So these are waterproof connections. Now remember, I've already marked this cable, this is the positive, and it's time to feed it through. Okay, here we go. This is what I've done so there's no mistakes. I marked positive on the left, negative on the right, and I did the same on the bottom. Now in this box, I had to drill two small holes so that my cables coming out of the solar charge controller will come out of this, underneath the frame, up to my battery box. Okay, I've got my cables pulled through. What I'm doing right now is using some xylene, cleaning up this whole metal plate. Get off any wax and grease and dirt so that SecoFlex will stick. Okay, now if you can close in upon this a little bit. Notice the cables? Got all four of them. The negatives are on the right, the positives are on the left. So I'm keeping them all the same. Now it's time to just glue this up, and I'm going to use some self-tapping screws, shoot through the body to hold this on. Oops. Now, I'm just putting in self-tapping screws. But this SecoFlex is probably going to keep this glued by itself anyway. There we go, we're done with that. That is a good watertight connection. No water is going to get in there at all. I put some SecoFlex around the holes on the inside. Now I'll get the other cable strap, put on this, and we'll get inside. Okay, I got my charge controller installed. It's not where I really want it, but there's not much room in here to put anything. So I got it hooked up here, and the instructions underneath are very easy. PV in, PV out. So you can't really make a mistake. We're done with that. One final thing to do is go outside and get the battery hooked up, and we're done. There's my cables coming through the wall, plus I anchored them down in here also with straps. So, okay, I got my cables all run, as you see here. I'm gonna use the SecoFlex on the bottom of these just for the heck of it. But you gotta make sure to zip tie all of this cable. You definitely don't want any loose cable around. If you're pulling this thing through the woods or whatever, you could get your cables pulled off. So zip tie it all up real good. All right, ready to make our connection, see if anything blows up, catches fire. That's always interesting. I've already got all my cables marked. I put some red tape on this one here. Well, there you go. Made my connections, and the battery's charging. Man, it was down to 8.6 volts. Unbelievable. Don't know why. All right, we're done with this. Well, I hope you liked that install. I'll leave it up to you how it come out. I think it's okay. Now, these brackets up here for the solar panels, they come in black or white. And I should have went with black on there. For some reason, I went with white. I don't know. But I think the install is pretty good. It's charging right now. And actually, we're in a pole barn, and that 50-watt panel is charging. So it's getting enough light, plus I'm using my portable set. Well, that's it for this video, and I hope you enjoyed it. I'm Jeff from Missouri Wind and Solar, and I'll catch you on the next video. And by the way, you can get all of these parts that I just showed you at Missouri Wind and Solar.